My name is Jimmy Raven. I'm the Fortify Product Manager, and I'm here today to talk to you about ScanCentral. ScanCentral is an evolution of a product we called CloudScan for a number of years. We're actually changing the name to ScanCentral in the next release. It provides a simple-to-use interface for integration of static analysis into the build process. It additionally provides the ability to dynamically scale the sensors that you need to perform the work that is required of the CI/CD pipeline with regards to running Fortify scans. We provide integrations out of the box with Maven, Gradle, MSBuild for easy packaging of code and instructions for sending remote translation and remote scan. And we have can automate this much more easily because the integration point is simply the build tool and the build file. We don't need the user to specify any options. We don't need the user to tell us anything specific about the language. If they are able to provide to us the build tool and the build file, we can automatically generate the instructions for SCA and provide a much more automatable experience that is much more scalable since all of the memory-intensive work is being done on remote machines. Let's take a quick look at the architecture. From a build perspective or wherever you compile code, you either have a copy of Fortify Static Code Analyzer here, or you have our ScanCentral packaging utility that you download as part of the ScanCentral package, and that's unzipped on the build server. Either one works. The controller is a basic web application that routes the files collected from the build server to an available copy of SCA. We have pools so that you can denote that certain scanning sensors be used for certain applications if that is necessary. And SSC is providing the command and administrative interface to basically monitor the queue, grab log files, ensure the health of sensors, add new sensors, things of that nature. All right, so let's take a quick look at ScanCentral. So if we're on Jenkins, for example, I'm going to show you how we can use ScanCentral with our Jenkins plugin. I'm going to quickly come in here to show you the options that I set up. All I'm doing is saying I want to do remote SCA translation and scan. I'm using Maven. I'm in the build directory, so I don't even have to specify the build file. And then I want to upload the results to SSC and what the application name is. So I'm going to go ahead and click Build Now, and this should generate a build for us. And we'll take a quick look at the console output, and it's retrieving the CloudScan controller URL, determines that it's up. It starts to initiate the build to generate that payload. That payload includes source, all the libraries that are necessary for SCA to do the work, as well as a spec file, which is instructions for SCA of how to do the best quality scan. ScanCentral is providing you that ease of use, ease of integration across a multitude of technology stacks, and providing a much more automatable way to drop in static analysis. So this has been executed, and now if we were to come into SSC, we can go ahead and refresh our scan queue, and we'll give that just a second to come up. So we can see, here is our scan. So we have our upload has been completed, our scan has finished. We could export the logs if we wanted to. If we had, if this was a long running scan, we could cancel the scan. We know exactly what machine is running on this. We could remote into that box if we felt like it to troubleshoot, but we should be able to export the log and determine what's going on from right here. All right, so now that we've done that through Jenkins, let's take a quick look at the command line just so you can better understand the command that's being generated under the covers. So if we are to take a look, this is the same pet store application. I'm simply have a command shell open into that directory, and I'm going to generate the command manually. So I'm specifying the cloud controller URL. I'm asking it to start a job. I'm telling it that the build tool is Maven. I am optionally using the dash save package here to save a local copy of the payload. That's just if you want to understand how the technology works. You can see what we are sending to the controller by storing a copy locally. And then we're going to upload that to SSC. This is a cloud controller token that we are providing here. Here is our authentication token that we are providing that gives us the ability to upload to SSC. That I generated from SSC's token management. And now I'm going to go ahead and run this. Controller is up. It's going to generate the payload as it did before. And we will be given a unique identifier once the payload has been created and shipped to the cloud controller. And we can check on the status of it from here. So here we go. So I'm going to use this command to ask for the status. So here's our unique token we were given, and we can go ahead and see that the job state is running. So our SCA scan is running and our upload state is queued. Hopefully this brief overview is helpful of what the technology provides and some of the benefits. And we are planning to provide more detailed videos in the future to go through installation, configuration, and all other types of different use cases of different technology stacks. But it really is very similar. And you know, if you're using a build tool like Maven or Gradle or MSBuild, it really is as easy as that to drop SCA into part of your build. Thank you very much.